Hello, this is the Tradesight US Stocks and Futures Market Preview and Domestic Economic Data Roadmap for the week beginning the 26th of January 2015 and ending on Friday the 30th, which will be the last trading day of the month. Lots to talk about for this next week. We've got a Fed meeting, we've got the end of month, we've got the last half of the core 8 days of earnings, all of which adds up to a confusing week at best. And probably with a dull ending just like we just had. So let's start by looking at the indices, and then we'll look at the intraday data from this last week to see what happened. It was four great trading days and then a bust on Friday, which was pretty much expected. Said that coming into the week. And then we will look at the economic data that's due and kind of map out what's ahead. So here's the ES. This is the S&P E-mini front month futures contract. Ended up climbing this week, up 5 days. Four of them solidly up. Well, actually, the fifth day was slightly down, but overall up for the week. We gave back 11 points on the S&P on Friday. Here's the NASDAQ 100 index. This cash index was up every day this week, including 7 points on Friday. Here's the SOX, kind of up for the week, but was only up one on Friday, actually down one. And the biotechs gained 17 on Friday, almost to a new closing high, although they were back and forth this week. A little bit flat. The VIX closed the week down at 16.66. Again, look at how solidly we're using that green static trend line as resistance, even on something like the VIX. Here's 45.40 for the close for the week on crude oil. That, I believe, is a new closing low. Let's see, there's one day in there. Take a look and see what it was. The close, 45.89. So yes, this is a new closing low on crude oil. Woo! And here's a look at gold. Up again. Volume for the week was pretty good most of the time, still averaging maybe just slightly under the 1.8 billion shares that we got up to, but it was core earnings week, and that does make a difference. We only traded 1.5 billion shares on Friday. All right, let's take a look at the action during the week and see what we got. We're going to look at it in 10-minute bars so you can see the whole week. So here it is now. Now, keep in mind, Monday was a holiday, so really, you can see last Friday's close, and then they do open the market for almost no reason for a couple hours Monday, and you can see the big volume hole where there's no volume. That's Monday. So from Friday's close to Tuesday's open, we gapped up, filled the gap, went a little lower, and recovered, gained a couple points on Monday. Tuesday, wide opening bar. We had actually gapped down initially and then shot up on some news out of Europe and kept going, pulled back a bit over lunch to about even, and then drifted higher into the close. Most of the ranges, you'll notice this is what earnings season looks like, core earnings. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday are the big earnings days. Look at all three of those days. Most of the range is established in the first hour, and then you kind of drift. At best, you get a run, a little move in late in the afternoon as they run into rumors of what's coming out after the bell or before the market the next day. So on Thursday, we gapped up and filled. Came back up near that area, tried to break the highs, came back in over lunch. We did move up late Thursday afternoon. Friday was as flat as could be, a small gap down, drifted up to fill it, and spent most of the day in about a 5-point range on the ES until the last hour at best, maybe even the last 20 minutes only. So that was really a waste of time, but we knew that because Fridays are slower, and the Friday in the middle of the core 8 days of earnings is often like that. Next Friday could be also slow because it is the last day of the month. A lot of stocks get pegged to their what the funds want them to be at for the statements. So we don't often see a lot on Friday. It might be a little better than this one, but not necessarily. I wouldn't expect much. So what do we do to map out the next week? Well, first of all, we're still in the core 8 days of earnings, so keep that in mind. That means that Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday are actually the biggest days. Thursday in particular are the biggest days of earnings. I know Microsoft's this week, Google comes out this week, but there's just a ton of stocks releasing this week. So be very careful of anything you hold. Look out for anything in the last half hour because other stocks in the sector might start to move due to rumors flying. And it's just a much more choppy time in the environment. If you can get something done in the first hour or hour and a half and you're profitable, either way, just be done and move on. Only trade beyond that if there's significant movement and volume in the market, which there usually isn't after that point. Here's a list of the data that's coming out. There are a couple things to know. First of all, Monday, no data. And again, it's the middle of the core 8 days of earnings, although most of the earnings aren't until Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So Monday should be a little wider than the Friday we just saw, but it might be a lot of hurry up and wait because we're still looking at all these earnings. Tuesday, we've got durable orders, the Case-Shiller 20-city index, that's a housing number, consumer confidence 30 minutes in, new home sales 30 minutes in. We also start a two-day Fed meeting, so you got to be aware of that, because on Wednesday, we've got the MBA mortgage index, we've got the weekly crude oil inventories number, we've got the Fed announcement at 2 p.m. Eastern time, so the market's going to be sitting around waiting for that most of Wednesday while they're waiting for earnings. So Wednesday's going to be a little unexciting, probably especially after the first hour. Initial and continuing jobless claims on Thursday, that's the weekly number, pending home sales, and then the weekly natty gas inventories number. And then Friday, here's a big one, done with earnings for the most part, but you're at end of quarter, but here's the one thing that could get you moving. The first look at fourth quarter gross domestic product, that's a big number, that's a once a quarter number. So that could move the market, and that's pre-market by an hour. Chicago PMI and Michigan sentiment. So again, you know, we focus on the middle of the week, but it is different than most of the time. You got to trade it like the earnings season that it is, and then see if that GDP number gets you any excitement Friday morning. Monday and then potentially Friday will be the lighter trading days of the week, I'm sure. After this, we're on to February. No more earnings for a couple of months. No more end of month. No more Fed meetings for a while. So we're free to trade like we were prior to this earnings season come the 1st of February. Have a great trading week. Charts, as usual, brought to you by eSignal 11 and 12. And if we're around to help you out in the trading lab all week long, please stop by so we can help you make some money. If you haven't taken a trial of our services, feel free to do so. If you do like these videos, please like them on YouTube. It does help us out. Have a great week.